भारत ने जैसे ही 2024 का T20 वर्ल्ड कप जीता, पूरे देश में खुशी की लहर दौड़ गई। लेकिन तीन बड़े खिलाड़ियों ने T20 क्रिकेट से संन्यास लेने की घोषणा कर डाली। सबसे पहले विराट कोहली ने T20 क्रिकेट मैच से संन्यास लेने की घोषणा की, उसके बाद कप्तान रोहित शर्मा ने भी साथ साथ यह घोषणा कर दी। उसके अगले ही दिन यानी आज टीम के एक और महत्वपूर्ण सदस्य रविंद्र जडेजा ने भी T20 क्रिकेट से संन्यास ले लिया। संन्यास लेने वाले यह तीनों खिलाड़ियों की उम्र 35 वर्ष से अधिक हो चुकी है। विराट कोहली की उम्र 35 वर्ष, रविंद्र जडेजा की उम्र भी 35 वर्ष और रोहित शर्मा की उम्र 36 वर्ष। इन तीनों ही खिलाड़ियों ने भारत के T20 क्रिकेट में काफी बड़ा योगदान दिया है। आइए बारी बारी से डालते हैं इन तीनों खिलाड़ियों के T20 मैचों में दिए गए योगदान पर एक नज़र। सबसे पहले बात करते हैं रोहित शर्मा की। रोहित शर्मा ने पूरी दुनिया में सबसे अधिक T20 मैच खेले हैं, 159 मैच। इन 159 मैचों में रोहित शर्मा ने कुल 4,231 रन बनाए। उनका स्ट्राइक रेट रहा 140.89 का, जबकि प्रति मैच उनका औसत रहा 31.34। इस दौरान रोहित शर्मा ने अपनी कप्तानी में 61 T20 मैच खेले, जिनमें 50 मैचों में उन्होंने जीत हासिल की। रोहित शर्मा को हिटमैन कहा जाता है, क्योंकि उन्होंने T20 इतिहास में सबसे अधिक 205 छक्के लगाए हैं। इसके अलावा रोहित शर्मा, जिन्होंने 2007 से लेकर अब तक खेले गए सभी T20 वर्ल्ड कप में हिस्सा लिया है, रोहित शर्मा ने अपने T20 करियर में कुल 5 शतक लगाए हैं, जो किसी भी खिलाड़ी द्वारा T20 में बनाए गए सर्वाधिक शतक है। उनका अधिकतम स्कोर 121 रहा है। अब आइए बात करते हैं विराट कोहली के T20 वर्ल्ड कप मैचों में रिकॉर्ड की। विराट कोहली ने अब तक कुल 125 T20 मैच खेले हैं, जिसमें उन्होंने कुल 4,188 रन बनाए हैं। उनका स्ट्राइक रेट 137.04 रहा और प्रति मैच उनका औसत 48.70 रहा। विराट कोहली ने अपनी T20 करियर में 1 शतक बनाया है और उनका सर्वोच्च स्कोर 122 है। अब आइए बात करते हैं रविंद्र जडेजा की। रविंद्र जडेजा ने कुल 74 T20 मैच खेले हैं, जिनमें उन्होंने कुल 515 रन बनाए हैं। उनका स्ट्राइक रेट 127.16 है, जबकि प्रति मैच उनका औसत 21.86 रहा है। T20 मैचों में रविंद्र जडेजा ने कुल 1,356 गेंद फेंकी है, जिनमें उन्होंने 1,612 रन देकर 54 विकेट हासिल किए हैं। रविंद्र जडेजा की गेंदबाजी का इकोनॉमिक रेट प्रति ओवर 7.13 रन है। अब भारत को तलाश है नए T20 कप्तान की, जिसमें 4 नाम पहली पंक्ति में बताए जा रहे हैं। इन 4 नामों में जसप्रीत बुमराह, हार्दिक पांड्या, सूर्य कुमार यादव और ऋषभ पंत के नाम शामिल है। अब देखना यह है कि किस खिलाड़ी को मिलता है T20 कप्तान का ताज। भारत अपना अगला T20 मैच आगामी 6 जुलाई को खेलेगा, लेकिन इस टीम इंडिया में वर्ल्ड कप जीतने वाले 11 खिलाड़ियों की टीम में से कोई भी खिलाड़ी शामिल नहीं है। यानी आप कह सकते हैं यह इंडिया की बी टीम है, जिनकी कप्तानी शुभमन गिल करेंगे। इस टीम में वर्ल्ड कप की टीम में शामिल 3 खिलाड़ियों यशस्वी जायसवाल, रिंकू सिंह और संजू सैमसन को शामिल किया गया है।
He more than any one of us, I think he deserved that trophy. What he has done for Indian cricket for the past 20-25 years, I think this was the only thing that was left in his cabinet, and I'm very happy from all of us on behalf of the entire team that we could actually do this for him. You saw how proud he was and how excited he was, and really grateful to the occasion for this to happen as well. Like, you know, in a game like this, there are a lot of turnarounds. I actually cannot single out one or two aspect of the game, but you know, looking at where the game was when 4 or 5 overs was left, obviously that wicket of Klaassen, when Hardik took that wicket, that was actually very crucial from our point of view. And then again, Miller's wicket at the back end, the last over, that catch of Surya of Hardik's bowling was again superb. But again, you can't forget what the batters did with the bat, Virat getting that runs, Akshar playing that part, and then eventually us finishing off with the score that we finished. And then obviously when we started with the ball, Bumrah, Arshdeep were superb, so I don't know how much I can talk about Bumrah. Obviously we've been seeing this with him for such a long time now. Whenever he has ball in hands, he tends to create magic for us every time. So yeah, I'm very lucky to have players like this in my squad, players who are playing for me and Team India. Really, really grateful and thankful as well.
Rohit, congratulations. And you have had so many moments of glory in your career and disappointments also, 2007 and 2008 CB series, 2013 and Australia Test series. Of course, 2011, you could not be part of the World Cup, and of course, Ahmedabad. Looking back at all these things, do you consider this as the greatest moment of your career? And second, 30 of 30 balls and 6 wickets, how could you motivate the players to, we can pull it off?
Yeah, this has to be the greatest time, I can say that. Because it's only because how desperately I wanted to win this. So all the runs, all the runs that I've scored in all these years, I think it does matter, but I'm not a big on stats and all of that. I think winning games for India, winning trophies for India, that is what I look forward to all the time. And having this now right besides me probably has to be, I don't know, honestly, I don't know if it's the greatest or what, but it is definitely one of the greatest, I can say that. And when I have to look back at certain moments in the game as well, they were really playing well. Halfway through the stage, we were very much in the game, and then the next 5 overs didn't go our way. Klassen and Miller actually took it on. De Kock played his part as well, but we know what they are capable with the bat. We do understand that. But again, you know, the message was very loud and clear to everyone that until the last ball of the game is bowled, the game is not over, because that's what happens in cricket, and you got to believe that. And my job as a captain is to make everyone believe that. Every time we had ball in hand, whether we got wickets or we didn't get wickets, we wanted to keep fighting, whether we are ahead in the game or whether we are behind in the game. We wanted to keep fighting, because the moments like this will never come again. This is the final, so you have to give everything that you have inside your body, mind and everything. And that is what the message was to everyone, that let everything out, put whatever you have in your body, mind, put it in front of us, and let's see then what happens. And I thought the belief that everyone had till the last ball was bowled was to keep fighting. Even though we were behind in the game after 15 overs, when they required just 30 odd runs in 5 or 4 overs, the belief was still there. We wanted to fight, and then eventually we managed to cross the line.
Rohit, since coming to the West Indies, India's batted first in all previous games coming into the final. So was that like a templated thing, or you thought the conditions deserved that, or did you think scoreboard pressure mattered in the final, or did all of this contribute to batting first here also?
I think I'm a believer of just having runs on the board in big games. That's how my mind works. It is not necessary that everyone thinks like that in the team, but like, I have a decision to make, and I made it very clear that no matter how the pitch is, whatever it is, we have to try and put runs on the board and then fight it out. You have the talent in your bowling, and I've seen what the guys have done with the ball. So I had that confidence that whatever score we have, we can try and defend it. And that's exactly what happened as well. I know the result came in our favor, but even though if the result didn't came in our favor, I would have still completely backed the decision of batting first. Although I thought the pitch really played well, you know, throughout the 40 overs, the pitch was really good. You know, it didn't grip as such, which we really thought it would after the first half. With the sun beating down so hard, there's no grass on the pitch, looks a lot drier. But obviously, you know, a lot of rolling water must have gone in there to make it nice and hard. But yeah, that was a thought, and we were very clear with that decision as well, that we want to put runs on the board and try and defend it later.
Rohit, hi. Firstly, congratulations. I wanted to ask you about Virat Kohli announcing his retirement today. How do you look back at his journey? You've shared some of the most ups and downs with him, your moments with him. Just how do you look back at all of it?
Look, he's been a champion player without a doubt. And we all know, you know, what he has done for us. You know, at some point, everyone has to say goodbye to the game. And, you know, Virat obviously was very clear that this is what he wanted to do. And he was very clear before the start of the tournament as well. And I'm very happy for him, you know, that he batted like he did in the finals. I know, you know, the quality that he has, you know, the big games and all of that. He's going to come good. And when we wanted him the most, he came out and performed the way he did. So, very happy looking at his career. Obviously, he's been a champion player. We know, we can see the stats and everything there. But, nice way to sign off from this format.
आखिरी वक्त पे गड़बड़ हो रही थी लास्ट कुछ टूर्नामेंट में, लेकिन हम कंसिस्टेंटली उधर नॉक कर रहे थे. क्या अच्छेपन पे विश्वास रखना मुश्किल हो रहा था और अच्छे लोगों के साथ अच्छा होना ज़रूरी है, चाहे आप हो, टीम हो, राहुल द्रविड़ हो, क्या ये ज़रूरी है राहुल?
ज़रूरी तो है. मैं बिलीव करता हूँ कि जो लिखा है वो होने वाला है. आई थिंक ये लिखा था, बट ऑब्वियसली तुमको पता नहीं है मैच के पहले कि ये लिखा है. यही तो खेल है, यही गेम है. नहीं तो हम लोग आराम से आते, चलो लिखा हुआ है जीतने वाले. बट जो आई थिंक यू नो एवरीथिंग हैज़ टू फॉल इन प्लेस. अभी जैसे आपने देखा कि हम बहुत पीछे थे गेम के, एक टाइम पे लग रहा था आसानी से जीत जाएंगे वो लोग. विकेट भी अच्छा चल रहा था, उनकी बैटिंग अच्छे से हो रही थी. हमारे बॉलर्स जो मुझे ऑप्शंस जो भी यूज़ करने थे, बुमराह का ओवर 18वें ओवर में ख़त्म हो गया था. तो ये सब चीज़ ज़रूरी था प्लान में फिट होना. और जैसे आपने बोला कि अच्छे लोग के साथ अच्छा होता है, आई मीन आपने बोल दिया मतलब मैं अच्छा हूँ. तो राहुल भाई भी नहीं अच्छा है. देखो हम लोग काफ़ी, राहुल भाई के लिए भी मैं बहुत खुश हूँ यार. उन्होंने इतना इंडियन क्रिकेट के लिए इतना कुछ किया है जब खेलते थे और अभी भी कोचिंग जब कर रहे हैं. पिछले 3 साल उन्होंने काफ़ी मेहनत किया इस टीम के साथ. उनके जो इंस्टिंक्ट्स है उनको काफ़ी बार दबाने पड़े, क्योंकि लड़कों का जो वेवलेंथ है वो मैच करना इतना आसान नहीं है. तो राहुल भाई ने अपने आप को दबाया, समझा कि लड़कों को क्या चाहिए, वो प्रायोरिटी आगे डाली. तो ये सब चीज़ करना किसी के लिए भी इतना आसान नहीं होता है. राहुल भाई ने वो चीज़ किया, पूरे टीम के लिए वो किया. उन्होंने समझा कि लड़कों को क्या ज़रूरत है, लड़कों को क्या देना ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि इवेंचुअली काम हम ही लोगों को करना है. राहुल भाई तो बैटिंग नहीं कर रहे. तो राहुल भाई का ये साथ देना टीम के लिए बहुत ज़रूरी था. और जैसे मैंने बोला कि उन्होंने इतने साल 3 साल एज अ कोच टीम के साथ इतना मेहनत किया है, लड़कों को इतना क्लियर रखा है कि आपका रोल क्या है, आपको क्या करना है. जो लड़के नहीं भी है इस टीम में, जो घर में भी है, उनके साथ भी लगातार बात करते रहना, उनको बताते रहना कि क्या हो रहा है टीम में, कब क्या बातचीत हो रही है, तुम कब टीम में आ सकते हो, अगर आओगे तो तुम्हारा क्या रोल होगा. ये सब चीज़ राहुल भाई इतने स्टूडियस तो है ही, तो उन्होंने ये चीज़ पे सबसे पहले ये चीज़ पे ध्यान दिया था जब वो आए थे कि हमको लड़कों को बताना है कि उनका उनसे हम क्या चाहते हैं, क्योंकि 11 के 11 लोग फोर्स है और वो फोर्स अगर एक साथ मिलके खेलेंगे तो एक बड़ा फोर्स बन सकता है। तो राहुल भाई ने उस चीज़ में काफ़ी साथ दिया मेरा भी और टीम को भी काफ़ी सपोर्ट किया।
Hi Rohit, congratulations first. You have spoken in bits and pieces about the last three overs. We almost died in the press box, but I would like you to go through those three overs in the end and what was the talk that was going on and how was Hardik being motivated in the last over?
I think the talk strategy wise it was very simple to try and make them hit on the other side of the wind. Because the wind was blowing across the ground quite rapidly and it was the average, and I don't know how much the average wind per hour and all of that was, but it was quite heavy. So the plan was to make them hit on the other side of the ground. And then obviously when Bumrah came to bowl that 18th over, as much as we wanted the wicket, we wanted to build that pressure as well on the opposition by bowling dot ball. So I had to get the fielders in the right place, getting the straighter fielders in, standing in front of the square, because I thought the nature of the wicket didn't allow batters to hit square of the pitch as much. It was easy to hit down the ground, and with Bumrah's angle, with the reverse swing coming in play a little bit as well, we knew that if we can bowl, if we can keep stumps in play as much as possible, the runs will be hard to come by as well. And if they make mistake by not getting the bat right where the ball is, there is a chance we can get a wicket as well. And Bumrah nearly knocked Miller off in the first ball, which he missed, and then he got wicket off Marco there. So that was crucial for us. That over was crucial, and then followed up greatly by Arshdeep as well. He gave a 3-over run. Bowled a 3-over run, and then in the end it was 16 or 17 required, and then the plan was to just slightly go outside of Miller's arc, don't give him any hands, Surya took a brilliant catch there, and then obviously it was just to bowl full to the other batters, not to give them any elevation, and it was very nice to see that Hardik was very calm as well. You know, no matter how many runs is required, you still got to bowl that over and bowl it well as well. So, for him to bowl that over and, getting that crucial wicket of Miller also was a very important from a team's standpoint.
Thank you.
Rohit, just that catch of Surya, like if you can just go through the emotions of him taking that catch and that weight, and do you think kind of this catch is on a par with Kapil's 83 catches?
No, 83 mein itna acha hua hai to usko rakho na udhar hi. Bahut badhiya catch tha wo. Ye bhi apna catch hai. In the hindsight, if you look at it, every moment that happens, it has its own charm, own way, so I don't like to compare it. I'm not a big comparison fan, but yeah, I was standing at long off, so I could clearly see Surya there, and he is very calm under pressure. He's got brilliant hands, and the moment he took that catch, I knew that he is inside. I was very calm. You could see I was celebrating already, but still, until the scoreboard says out, it's not out yet. So, but I knew that it was an out, and I started already thinking about the other five balls that we have to bowl to the other batters.
And Rohit, like on your own international career, do you think you will be there for a while longer? Like, how do you see yourself?
No, this was my last game as well. Honestly, I've enjoyed since the time I started playing this format, and nothing better time to say goodbye to this format. I've loved every moment of this. I started my India career playing this format, and this is what I wanted. I wanted to win the cup and say
Thank you.
Right, is that just T20s, just to check?
Yeah.
Just T20s international? Yeah. Can you just, so you still play ODIs and tests?
Yeah, very much.
When you sunk to your knees at the end, what was going through your head at that point? When you dropped to your knees at the end after the final ball,
it was very emotional. I wanted this badly. So very hard to put it in words because that moment, I don't want to say what I was thinking and what was going in my mind, but it was a very emotional moment personally for me. And I wish I could capture that moment myself, but not really, can't do that. But I will always remember that. Those are the moments you wait for, and then you don't plan these things. It just happens because you're so desperate for certain things in life. And I was very desperate for this in my life. So happy that we eventually crossed the line this time.
Thank you.